Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station where we are going to interact and learn together. We are going to have our biology from 4 lesson 8, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on evolution and the subtopic, the origin of life. Remember, life must have started from somewhere, and this is we are going to discuss where life started in this lesson. But before that, we are going to have the following lesson goal, whereby by the end of the lesson, we should be able to identify the theories of evolution. We are going first, before we get into the origin of life, we are going to have, you can see at the meaning of evolution, whereby you can say evolution is a gradual change of living organisms from simple life forms to more complex forms over a period of time. Actually, there are so many theories which have explained the origin of life. Various theories have been put forward that seeks to explain the origin of life. We are going to, in this lesson, we only address the religious view, which is the theory of special creation, and the scientific view, that is the theory of chemical evolution. So now we are going to start with what we call the special creation theory. For a long time, the answer to the question of how life first began and how the great variety of animals and plants came into existence was provided by religious writings, such as the Bible and the Quran. This narrates that the whole universe and all it contains was created by the action of a supreme being, whereby the supreme being it refers to it as God. To create means to bring into existence something out of nothing. This belief is called a special creation. This belief holds the following views on the origin and nature of life. 1. That life was brought into existence by a supreme being, which is mostly referred to as God. That life forms were created in a perfect form and have remained unchanged over time. 3. That this knowledge is based on faith and cannot be disputed. Actually, in this special creation, we only deal with faith. So it is only faith that makes us to believe about the special creation, because I'm very sure you also question yourself, whereby this supernatural being came from, but we just believe that he was there. This belief is held by all the world's major religions and is also found in the folklore. This belief cannot be contradicted by science, since it is not scientifically testable. But now the scientists came up with other theories, which we have what we call the chemical theory. This is another theory that I try to explain the origin of life, which was brought about by several scientists. This is the scientific view of the origin of life on Earth. The theory of chemical evolution supposes that life probably began through a catalytic effect of lightning or some other catalyst, bringing together elements to form simple molecules, such as our diagrammatic representation here is trying to show the components which combined to bring about life. So that is what I'm going to explain. So this one is showing that we are saying that this theory of chemical evolution supposes that life probably began through a catalytic effect of lightning or some other catalyst, bringing together elements to form simple molecules such as water, ammonia, and methane. We can see that water is being represented by H2O. We have got methane, which is CH4, that is a component of carbon and hydrogen, and we have got ammonia, which is NH2. Now, various experiments have been carried out in the lab to artificially stimulate conditions that could have led to the initial formation of the organic molecules. For example, there is a scientist who was known as Miller in the year 1953, an American scientist, successfully produced 4 of the 20 known amino acids by basically passing a spark through a mixture of hydrogen, methane, water vapor, and ammonia. The high temperature and pressure conditions used by Miller to synthesize these amino acids were possibly similar to those existing in the new universe when life started. So actually, this chemical evolution is trying to contradict our theory that we have looked earlier on, which is the special creation. From the results of the Miller's experiments, it can be theorized that millions of years ago, simple molecules such as hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen in the primitive Earth's atmosphere combined in various portions to form different simple compounds, which include water and ammonia. Further combinations of such compounds possibly resulted in the formation of complex self-replicating molecules resembling the present-day DNA, which forms the genetic material of living cells. Successive replications of these molecules and further development probably led to the formation of simple forms of the first living cells. These cells might have resembled present-day viruses and bacteria. Therefore, the theory of chemical evolution supposes that chemicals combine to form the first living organisms. As you can see from our diagrammatic presentation, there are several chemicals which are combining to form life. This happened between 4 to 3 billion years ago. The theory of chemical evolution of life holds the following views on the origin and nature of life. The first view is that life came into existence through combination of chemicals. The second view is that the initial life forms were simple and have changed over the years to form the present and complex organisms. This is the principle of organic evolution. And the third view is that scientific evidences in the form of experiments, artifacts, and fossils back this theory. To appreciate how the first living organisms arose on Earth, it is necessary to understand the condition on Earth during this primitive time and the changes that have taken place since then. This helps in the reconstruction of the chronology of events in order to understand the process of evolutionary changes. It is theorized that the universe came into existence over 15 billion years ago. So actually, we have got what we call the fossil records of the primitive prokaryotes. The prokaryotes are actually the organisms that lack the cell membrane. They date back about 1,000 million years ago. So in generally, actually, there are so many theories which explain the origin of life. But basically, here we are dealt with two of them, which is the special creation and what we are calling the chemical evolution theory. So to sum it up, we have just said that in this chemical evolution, that the different chemicals, they combine to form life, simple life forms, which then we have said that they could be involving the prokaryotes, that is the viruses. Having done and said that, you are going to have the following activity, whereby you are required to explain the chemical evolution theory. And to get more information of our lesson, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Biology Student Book 4, which is the 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Research Bureau. And you can also get many more of our biology lessons by sending us an SMS to the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to either YouTube or our Facebook page, which are both Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV underscore Kenya. Let us subscribe to all these channels, such that we can enjoy more of our biology lessons. You're welcome.